Welcome back to another lab solution. In this video, we are going to solve developing a custom gadget chain for Java deserialization, in which here we will find two main Java classes, where in one in particular we can perform some SQL injection in order to get access to the admin user, and after that delete the user Carlos. As usual, we need to use Burp Suite to perform this request, and we need to intercept the request my account, in which inside there is stored the cookie session, which this one, once hacked, we allow us to perform an attack inside this web server. But as you can see, there is this directory backup where we can find some Java classes. One is the access token user, and if we erase the path and just we surf into the backup root directory, we can find another interesting class, product template.java. This will be the one that we need to inject SQL inside. As you can see, there is the ID of the classes is where with this ID is performed an SQL query, and so we need to create a serialization with a new object, a product template.java, in which we can try to insert some SQL injection inside. I have created a repository where we can find a sample of code which will be utilized during this video, but at the end of this video I will update it to allow you to get the solution without all the trouble that I found during the recording of this video. As you can see, if we get into the repository, into the Java directory, you can find the main.java class sample. We need to change it a little bit. As you can see, I was trying to build it on my computer, and you need to perform some action. In this video, I will cut some part of it because I was troubling a little bit with some error by the Java compiler. So I think in the description of this video I will place the GitHub repository with the code updated, where you can insert inside the SQL injection. But I suggest you to try to find out a solution without utilizing direct solution. First, I suggest you to try alone, and if you find trouble after several tries, you can search for the solution, but you need to comprehend it in order to be able to perform other attacks to be successful in these labs. As you can see, we need also to create the class product empty, just to allow the product template.java to build successfully. After this, as you can see, there is still some error that I made, but after some tentatives I was able to understand where was the error. Now I would like to show you the steps that usually you need to take when you want to perform an SQL injection and you are clear, you have clear in your mind what is the main purpose, the objective that you want to follow. In this case, we need to retrieve the administrator password, so we need to get into the database all the tables, all the columns, in order to get into the right one. The first steps usually that we can take during the SQL injection is to insert this common query with the or 1=1 and --- to insert the comment, and just to be sure that we can insert an SQL injection. As you can see, if we run this type of command, we will get an error, and this will indicate us that we are able to perform an SQL injection. So now this is the main the first query interesting that we can use. I have already tried several times, but the main purpose in this case is to find out the right number of column, because once we have the right number of column, we can proceed with other steps in order to retrieve other tables, column, and etc. So as you can see right now, if I build this program and I insert this cookie session into the request, I will get still an error by SQL, which indicates us that there is still more column to be taken, less or more. If we delete one of these, we will have the right number of columns, which was 8 columns. And as you can see, this error indicates us that the SQL injection is successfully submitted. So we will try to, as you can see, this is another query that I don't want to use right now, but this indicates me that the column 4 has inside an integer value. And as you can see, if we launch this query with the cast as integer in the first column, we can retrieve the name of the table. In fact, as you can see, the name of the table is user. Now that we have retrieved the username table, inside we can perform other queries in order to get the column available. In this case, we can perform this one with, as usual, as a previous, as pre as the previous query, the cast into the column name as numeric. And as you can see, we will retrieve the name of the column, which is the username. And now we can perform other queries in the username column in order to get the real name of the user. So right now, let's copy the cookie session. And as you can see, if we run this cookie, we have the name administrator. After this, we can finally try to retrieve the password. As you can see, I already tried a different query to get the two columns, but I was having an error. So the right one is this last one, where at the same place where we previously cast the username, now we will cast the password. And if we compile this class and we copy the cookie session into the Burp Suite, we will get the password for the administrator. Finally, let's get to the my account and let's access with the administrator and the password. And as you can see, we will be able to delete the user Carlos and solve the lab. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like and subscribe. See you in the future.